I've talked a lot about shared web hosting plans on this channel. It's the budget option when you're choosing web hosting, since you have to share server resources with other people. But there's actually a completely different category of web hosting, usually referred to as managed or dedicated hosting, where you get a server all of your own. So that means no sharing. In this video, I want to talk about WP Engine, a company that actually specializes in managed WordPress hosting. Can be the hero with low prices and amazing speed that's able to make managed hosting the default choice? Or will it just be another black hole to suck all of your cash in? The only way to find out is, well, to test the shit out of WP Engine plans. So here's everything you need to know before you buy. On their website, WP Engine claims they're offering the best WordPress hosting based around a unique architecture that delivers speed, scalability, and security. On paper, this sounds amazing. One little problem though. Their plans start at $25 a month and end at a staggering $828 a month. First, let's make something really clear. If you're a complete beginner, this is your first website, don't even look at WP Engine. It's going to be overpriced and overwhelming for you. It's more meant as a tool for businesses, e-commerce, creative agencies, or freelance developers. If you're a complete beginner, I actually recommend you check out Hostinger. I leave a review right around here. That being said, if you're familiar with hosting and you only need to create one website, you don't plan to create more, these starter plans for $25 a month might actually be worth it for you. The tools you get that I'll cover a bit later will help you manage your website like a professional and remove a lot of manual labor and room for error. The growth plan for $95 a month, however, is absolutely not worth it. It allows you to host 10 websites and in theory, it should work great for freelancers and small agencies. The reality, however, is that there's a major downside. You barely get any resources to work with. With the starter plan, you get 10 gigabytes of storage for one website. With the growth plan, you get 10 times the amount of websites, but only 2 times the amount of storage. See how there's a problem? A measly 20 gigabytes of storage space shared between 10 websites is simply not enough. On average, this will allow you to create websites that take up around 2 gigabytes of space. But here's the problem. An empty WordPress website already takes up from 500 megabytes to 1 gig. So you just don't have enough flexibility if you want to create something that's actually good. If you plan to get WP Engine as a freelancer or an agency, your best option is to buy the scale plan or above. Because with the scale plan, you finally get enough websites to host as a business, which is 30, and you get enough space and bandwidth to comfortably share the resources between all 30 websites. While the $250 a month price tag might seem insane, and honestly it is if you're just hosting one website, it's actually quite cheap once we start to scale. If you're hosting 20 to 30 websites, that's around $10 per month per website. And you're getting top of the line performance, so your clients won't be disappointed. I would say that's honestly quite a good deal. And speaking of performance, let's hear from today's sponsor. I'm just kidding, this ain't Linus Tech Tips. I ain't got no sponsors. But actually, viewers like you are the sponsors of this video because every single video I made is sponsored by affiliate commissions. What I mean by this is if you make any purchases using the links in the description, I'll get a small commission, and in most cases, you'll get a discount because I'm actively negotiating discounts for my viewers. So thank you for supporting, or should I say sponsoring, the channel that allow me to make videos just like this. Let's get back to this review, and it just means a lot, so thank you. Let's spend some of that commission money and buy a WP Engine plan to test out. I'll get the starter plan for one website and I'll perform all of the tests on it. I'll also get the Global Edge Security to see if it's worth it and the Smart Plugin Manager just to make it a nice round $700 for 1 year. One thing to be aware of is that WP Engine doesn't even allow you to buy a domain name, and you don't get a domain name with any of their plans. Doesn't even matter if you spend $100 or $1,000. And this just goes to show that WP Engine isn't really beginner friendly, since you'll need to buy a domain name elsewhere and then connect it to your WP Engine account. Okay, here's how your dashboard will look after purchase. It's super simple and a clean design that actually I can get behind. Creating and managing your sites is also quite an easy task. Simply click the Add Site button, type in the name you want to assign to the site, and select which group it belongs to. And this grouping tool actually shows that WP Engine is positioning itself as a service to manage multiple websites at once, allowing you to create different groups for different clients or niches. Think of them as folders where you can put different websites in, so you don't lose track of which websites belongs to whom. If that makes any sense. I hope it does. Once you're done filling in all of the information, your website will be created automatically. It will have a temporary domain name, for example, mine has emitreviewsite.wpengine.com, and you'll be able to access the WordPress dashboard right away. Keep in mind that WP Engine, as the name would suggest, only allows you to use WordPress. But it's a modded version of WordPress, which comes with some quirks. For one, you cannot install some plugins because they conflict with the internal systems of WP Engine. It's not a big deal, it's more to keep your site as fast as possible and reduce the risk of failure. These mostly include caching, backup, and email management plugins. Okay, so all of this is nice and good, but it's nothing that I haven't seen before. So why the hell do these plans cost $25 per month for just a single website? What are they doing so special that shared web hosting plans just can't offer?
For one, when creating your website, you're actually getting three separate work environments. One live version of your website called the production. This is basically what the user sees at all times. Then you get the staging website. It's a copy of your production site. Users don't see this site, but since it's a copy, you can test any changes you make here before going live. If something is wrong, you would know beforehand.
And then there's the development environment, where you're actually making all of the changes. This allows you to work with multiple versions and multiple iterations of your website at the same time. Think of it like this. You make all of the changes on the development environment. Then you test those changes on the staging environment. If everything's okay, then you move that to the live version. And the user, it never sees any of your mistakes because, well, you tested for that. By the way, if you remember at the start of this video, I bought like $400 or $500 worth of extra tools to test out, and I'll get around to that a little bit later in this video, but for now I want to see how well the WP Engine base plan performs compared to something like shared web hosting.
To get a general idea of how well these $25 a month plans perform, we first need a baseline. Something to compare it to. So I've used my A2 hosting and SiteGround shared web hosting plans. That cost a little bit less than the WP Engine one, around 15 bucks a month on average. I've tested the exact same design on SiteGround, A2 hosting, and WP Engine by creating demo sites. SiteGround loaded this site in around 1.8 seconds. A2 hosting was pretty much the same, coming in at 1.9 seconds. However, WP Engine managed to load this site in 1.4 seconds.
0.4 seconds might not seem like all that big of a difference, but it is. Trust me, it is a big difference. It's actually 22% faster, and that's with absolutely no users on my website at all. If we would scale the website up to thousands of users, the 0.4 second difference scales together with the user count, so it's a big deal.
WP Engine manages to offer better performance than shared web hosting plans, even expensive ones in this case, simply because you're not sharing resources with other users. You're getting better, more consistent performance of your website for a similar cost that the top shared web hosting plans charge.
Just for fun, I've also sent some bots to my website to see how well it handles stress. To be exact, I've sent 50 bots for 5 minutes to see if any slowdown happens during this period.
To my surprise, yeah, a slowdown does happen. And honestly, I wasn't expecting this. According to the tool that I'm using, at 50 users, my website started to experience issues. Minimal, but still noticeable. This shows that at least the cheapest plan is evaluated quite accurately and does perform best if you're getting less than 25,000 monthly visits.
I'll be the first one to admit that 50 users doesn't seem like a big number, but it's actually much larger than you would expect because this is 50 users at the same time. You need to keep in mind that users usually stay on your website for seconds or minutes at a time. So keeping up constant 50 users on your website for all 24 hours while users keep leaving after like 10 or 15 seconds is quite a big accomplishment. It needs hundreds of thousands of visits per month at least to keep these numbers, I would say.
One extremely important feature when it comes to performance is the ability to choose the physical location of the server where your website files are being stored. WP Engine has servers all over the world, 7 locations to be exact. Having your website files stored closer to your users will reduce the distance the information needs to travel and will load your site faster for that user. And this isn't some trivial, barely noticeable speed increase. Sometimes having the server in the right location can mean seconds shade off loading speeds. For example, here, the bottom result is the test from the USA. The top result is the test from Canada. Same website, same design, different locations, meaning different loading speeds.
Okay, so let's get to the juicy bits. What are those features that I bought for $400 a year? Are they necessary and are they any good?
The GES, or Global Edge Security, is mainly used to reroute and sort traffic and helps defend against DDoS attacks. A DDoS attack is when someone sends a bunch of bots to your site to make thousands of requests per second, effectively draining your website resources so it either starts loading incredibly slow or crashes altogether.
So remember how previously we ran into issues with 50 bots on our website at the same time? Well, imagine that. Just a billion times worse, because these attacks can last for days and you're getting hundreds of thousands of requests on your website every single millisecond. And the worst part, they're not even that hard to do. A teenager could look up a tutorial and mess with your website just for shits and giggles.
Global Edge Security makes sure this doesn't happen by blocking bots, changing your IP addresses, using a firewall to sort through real traffic and fake traffic. Is it mandatory? Absolutely not. But if you're running a profitable website, there's always going to be people that want to hurt you. Competitors, ransom seekers, just bored teenagers all have the ability to take a crack at your site. So extra security tools like these are highly recommended if you're running a profitable website. The other tool I purchased is called the Smart Plugin Manager. This effectively works as an auto-updater for your site. It takes care of all the updates for your site automatically.
But wait, I can hear you asking. Well, I can't really hear you, but for this one very specific scenario, let's pretend that I do. Aren't automatic updates a terrible idea for your website because you're never sure if the update is compatible with other features on your website? In the past, I specifically had instances where my website would just completely break due to an update because suddenly things stopped working or started interfering with other things and my website was just, nah, I'm done with this, I'm out.
Well, credit where credit is due, the WP Engine engineers actually thought of this. The way the Smart Plugin Manager works is it actually creates a copy of your site and tests all of the plugin updates automatically, one by one on the copy. If everything works fine, it goes ahead and updates the live version. If you only have one site, this tool is definitely not worth your money. $100 a year for auto updates is laughable. However, if you have like 10 or 20 or 100 websites, this is an incredibly valuable tool in terms of security and time saved. Not having to manage updates for multiple sites by hand is definitely something your clients and you will appreciate.
I recommend the WP Engine mostly to agencies, freelancers, or multi-site owners. If you've never created a website before and you're a complete beginner, you will run into issues. So I recommend you don't choose WP Engine and go with something easier like Hostinger. They will take care of almost everything for you automatically. I leave a link for that down in the description below.
However, if you've created websites before, if you've managed websites before, and you want a fast, stable, feature-packed deal for your website, the single website plan of WP Engine is worth a look, but only for small to mid-sized sites.
Because you can't really grow as a single site owner on WP Engine. If you buy their more expensive plans, it won't make one of your sites faster. It will just give you the ability to host more websites and manage more websites. If you just have one, why do you need that? If you actually want to grow one website to a large scale with a service like this, I recommend you check out Liquid Web. I actually have a review on my channel that I'll upload in the upcoming weeks, depending on when you're watching this video. I haven't finished editing it yet. If you plan to use WP Engine, go ahead and use the links in the description down below to get a discount and help me make more content in the future. This really helps the channel out. But for now, I hope you learned something. I hope this video was helpful to you. And if it was, consider dropping a like or a subscribe. It's a small thing that will take like a second, and it actually really helps my channel grow and get recognized by YouTube. As always, good luck making your websites, and I'll see you in the next video.